pray. Our dear Heavenly Father, we want to thank you for your mercy. Thank you for preserving our lives. And thank you for enabling us to come to this sanctuary today. Father, we come here empty, waiting to be filled by you. We pray, Father, that as we share your word, you're going to help me so that I can speak to your people a word that will encourage them and encourage me as well. We pray this through Jesus Christ, our Savior.
Amen. Amen.
Take your seats. I greet you all in the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Good morning.
Good morning.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
May I take this opportunity to thank the vicar and the leadership of this church for giving me this opportunity to come and share the word of God with us. I'm called Isaac Karuga, and besides that, I love Jesus Christ as my personal Savior. I've seen him taking me from strength to strength. He has enabled me to go through many things, especially this year. And I can stand here and confidently say that the joy of the Lord is my strength.
Amen.
We are now in a new series. It's more related to what we went through last week. You remember last week we were talking about having a change of mind and how we find strength in changing our minds. So today we're in a new series related to that, and that is focusing more on God than focusing on our problems. By the wisdom that has been imparted to our vicar by God, he gave us this topic to talk about, focusing on God rather than our problems. You know, when you want to focus on something, nowadays we use digital cameras. If you want to take someone's photo, you just need to point it at them. Then on your screen, you'll get two squares that show where the smile is, maybe the eyes. And then the camera can sense that this person is smiling and it can take a photo. Long ago, we used to use cameras that were not digital. So you had to focus until you get the perfect picture that you want. Then you take the photo. So focusing is where you concentrate all your efforts. Where do you concentrate your efforts or your energies? What is your focus? And then the other word that we're using here is problems or troubles. You know, indeed, in this world, people go through problems. More so us Christians, More so this year. This year has been a very tough year. I can tell you of a story of a person who we work with, one of the people we do businesses with around where I work. At the beginning of this year, when things began, when there was a lockdown of Nairobi, his business started dwindling to the point that now he couldn't afford rent of the shop premises. But the owner of the business is benevolent. So he told him, you just try and make sure that you do something. So he was waiting on this person to pay his rent. But since March, now we are in November, he was unable to. But what happened in between was also not very easy, because he also used to live near there. And you know, at some point in the year, we had a fire. So one of the people who were affected was him, because besides where he was working, not even where he lived, he lost everything. So now, from there, his mother upcountry fell sick. Now he didn't even have fare to go and see his mother while she was in bed, while she was bedridden. Now we are counting months. So the day he was able to afford fare to go and see his mother, that day she died. Yeah? So And at the same time, this person, the business, the premises owner, had given him a deadline that if it reaches on the 5th of November, now that I've given you all this time to pay something and you're unable to, when it gets to the 5th of November, please, if you're unable to give me anything, you'll have to vacate the premise. And it so happened that the burial of his mother was on the 5th of November. So that's what happened, eh? He had to be evicted. Now, up country, where he was burying his mother, he had built a house, you know, we people from Central Kenya, eh? Where his house is where was supposed to be his brother's place. Now that his mother was gone, his brother told him, now that our mom is not here, I'm giving you 1 week. You demolish this house that you put here and take it to your side because I want to use this place. Yeah, those are troubles, eh? People go through troubles. Today we're being told, don't focus on your troubles, focus on God instead. We've gone through many troubles. You know, when you focus on your own troubles yourself, it brings out other things. One of the things that comes out when you focus on your troubles is anger. You become a very angry person because you're sort of helpless. You're wondering, why is this thing happening just to me? So you have to vent it out on someone else. That means all the time you'll be angry. No one, you're not even smiling at anyone. You're waiting for someone to throw a word at you so that you can tell them something bad. You'll be always angry. That's what happens when you focus on your sins, on your troubles. And mind you, these troubles can come out of your own volition, or someone else can cause trouble on you. We have many things. We have court cases. We have debts. We have, nowadays we have fuliza, eh? All the time there are things that are causing us a lot of problems or troubles. So when you're an angry person, because of focusing on your trouble, the other thing that will come together with that is violence. You end up being violent because of focusing on what? On your troubles. You remember Peter? When he was with Jesus, when Jesus was being arrested, instead of focusing on God, he focused on the problems that were around that time. So what did he do? He reached for his sword and slashed the ear of one of the temple guards. Violence is associated with focusing on your troubles. And inevitably, focusing on your troubles will lead you to sin. You remember David? He focused on his troubles when he caused upon himself some problems. When he went into the house of someone else, took upon himself someone else's wife. So what did he do? He continued sinning more and more because he's focusing on his troubles or on his problems. Another thing that will come when you're focusing on your troubles or your problems is depression. You know, we are being told by scientists that people who recover from COVID, because there are many, more than half of them will get mental illness because of the things they've gone through, troubles. You remember Job? Job, if you read in Job 3:11, he had depression because of his troubles, to the point that he was actually saying, I wish I was never born. When you focus on your troubles, it might reach to that point when you want to say, I just wish I was never born. Some people will say, I would rather take this rope. That's what happens when you focus on your troubles. And when you do some of those things, it will eventually lead to your condemnation. You will miss going into heaven. That's why we were reading in Matthew 6:25. And it says here, why are you worried about food and drink? you need in order to stay alive. Or about clothes for your body. For all, after all, isn't life worth more than food? Isn't the body worth more than clothes? And then we are told, instead, this is verse 36, be concerned about everything else. Instead, be concerned about everything else with the kingdom of God. With what? And with what he requires of you. And he will provide you with all these other things. In other versions it says, instead seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness. And all these things will be added unto you. That means then we should more be focusing more on God than our troubles. Because troubles will always be here. And when you focus on troubles, what happens to you? When you focus on God rather than your troubles, you get power. Look at the three men, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. When they were about to be thrown into the furnace, instead of thinking about their troubles and the way they were facing death, they continued praising their God, and they survived. They got power. You get peace when you concentrate on God. When you focus on God, you remember Jesus, when he was about to be crucified, he said, my heart is troubled, the flesh is weak, but it's your will. He concentrated on God's will, and he got power. He had peace when he was facing his death. And what happened after that? You get victory. When you concentrate on God rather than your troubles, you'll overcome these things. You know, in this world, there are people called politicians, eh? You know, the only difference between, we are told, eh? As long as there are problems, they'll always be politicians. If you go to any class of philosophy, you'll be told that politicians are there trying to solve problems, eh? But the difference between a political leader and a religious leader, like the one we have here, the political leader will always want you to concentrate on your problems rather than on God. That's why if our politician was to come here right now, instead of seeing the way this church is full of people, he'll start telling us we need a road here, that this place is not very conducive. Politicians will make you concentrate on your problems. That is why they'll tell you, for you to be able to live well in this world, you have to eliminate that community. They want you to see problems in other people. But that's not how it is with us Christians. Us, to be able to overcome our problems, we focus on God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
That's what we are told in Hebrews. Hebrews 12. I'm going to read verse 2. It says, let us keep our eyes fixed on Jesus, on whom our faith depends. From the beginning to the end, he did not give up because of the cross. On the contrary, because of the joy that was waiting him, he thought nothing of the disgrace of dying on the cross, and is now seated at the right-hand side of God's throne. Hallelujah.
Amen.
We need to be concentrating on Christ. I'm talking about us concentrating on God, and yet some of us may not know this God that we're talking about. So how do you have hope? How are you going to fight your troubles? Who are you going to be concentrating on? We need to turn to Jesus, especially these days, and concentrate on him. That's where our focus will be, and we'll be overcomers. Do you know this Christ? Let us pray. We thank you, Jesus, because of encouraging us with your words. Continue dwelling in our hearts so that we may continue concentrating on you the author and perfecter of our lives. We pray this through Jesus Christ, our Savior.
Amen.
I want to request Divine just to 1 or 2 minutes instead of the Divine, just to pray for the Christians, to pray for us, that we focus more on God.
Amen. Father, we thank you because you are awesome. We thank you because you are wonderful. We thank you because you are worthy. We thank you because there is none like unto thee. Thank you because you are God that can never fail. Thank you because from ages to ages, from generation to generation, you remain the same. As old as you are, you can never change. You can never lose your memory. You are still God who keeps back to your words. I worship you. I respect your majesty this very morning because you are awesome. Thank you because heaven and earth are full of your glory. Thank you for Saint Abba. Thank you for the vicar. Thank you for the evangelists of this church, the leaders of this church. Thank you for every soul in this church. Thank you because you are the keeper of their life.
Yes.
Thank you because without thee, they can do nothing. Thank you because it is by your grace they are living. Thank you because many are here in the mortuary, but they are alive. Thank you because it's not by their righteousness that they are living today, but because of your love towards their life that kept them. Let your name be magnified. Let your name be glorified because you are awesome God. In the name of Jesus. Father, talk about depression today. There's many people who are passing one dysfunction or the other. Many are sick in their inner mind, even when people don't know what is wrong with them. Many are passing one problem or the other. Many are passing one sickness or the other. Even when they appear, they look good. But inside them, they are being hurt. Father, we pray you go to visit them. Lord, some of them are here in your presence. Father, we pray, oh God, no matter what they are passing through, no matter what is eating them up, let your power descend upon them. Let your anointing descend upon them. Let every yoke in their life be broken. Bible says in Isaiah 10:27, and this body shall be taken off their shoulder. Every yoke shall be broken by the reason of the anointing. Lord, I don't care to know whatever they are passing through. I don't care to know the night is being come. I don't care to know what the state of their problem, the sickness they are passing through. But when I was saying, I shall declare a word, heaven will make you stand firm. I stand as an oracle and I pass a decree, O God, under their roof this morning. Everything that is eating them up, anything that is standing against their life, every depression, every challenge that is speaking against their life, whatever voice that is speaking against them, God, I stand in your name. I come against them now. I speak, let the blood of Jesus begin to rest them now. Begin to destroy them now. Whatever stand as a challenge upon their life, upon their families, upon the place of works, I don't care to know. But as in that written in Philippians 2:9-11, Bible says his name is highly exalted above every other name. At the mention of this name, every sickness shall disappear. Every problem shall disappear. Everything impossible will become possible. I begin to announce on their life. Let everything speaking in their life be rewritten now. Be disappeared now. Let their power from above descend upon their life. Let there be a new name. Let there be an open door. Let there be a new story. Bible says in the days of Jabez, it was just like that in Chronicles 4. And because this name has eaten him up, this name has bring depression upon him, this name has caused problems in his life,
and this man began to shed tears. The Bible recognized that he was born with a great destiny, with a potential, but because a bad name was given to him and it began to work against him. Any name given to your life that is speaking against your life, that's speaking against your finances, that's speaking against your job, I command fire to destroy them now. I command fire to erase them now. In the name of Jesus, from today, I declare you a winner. From today, I declare you a favorable man, a favorable woman. That place you stamp your foot that they rejected you, after today I prophesy, you will go there and they will accept you. Every voice from your family speaking against your life, I shut them up now. I shut them up now. They will never speak again in your life. In the name of Jesus. Bible says in 1 book of John chapter 4 verse 4, greater is he that is in me than he that is in the world. And Bible says, when you pass them, the lesson I was talking about, I pass a decree in the name of Jesus. Let everything speaking in your life be destroyed now. Father, receive praise in their lives. Take all the glory because you're awesome God. Let this week be a blessed week upon your life. Let this week yield fruit in your life. I disconnect you from this depression. I disconnect you from anger. I disconnect you from anything that devil has installed in your life that is causing problems in your life. By the name of Jesus, let them be destroyed now. Father, I speak. This week shall be a week of testimony upon their lives. This week shall be a week of miracle upon their life. Whatever you lay your hands, this week shall prosper. The Lord will open his windows of blessing and shower it upon your life. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus, for hearkening to the voice of your people. For we pray in the mighty name of Jesus Christ.
Amen. Amen. Let us clap for the Lord. Amen. Amen.